What happens in the spiritual world when I use anointing oil? For all the promises of God in Him are yes, and in Him, amen, to the glory of God through us. Now He who establishes us with you in Christ and has anointed us is God, who also has sealed us and given us the Spirit in our hearts as a guarantee. That's what 2 Corinthians 1 verse 20 to 22 says. When you anoint yourself combined with faith in the Word of God for your situation, then God's power is being released in that situation. Does it mean that nothing will ever happen anymore? No. Your faith will be tested. You still will need to go through trials while keeping your eyes fixed upon Jesus and His Word. But those who remain standing will see the promise fulfilled. When Jesus was tempted by the devil, it had a beginning and an end. When he remained standing, the devil left him and the angels came to serve him. After that, his earthly ministry started. We have heard so many testimonies from people who started to use anointing oil. Some would call us to tell us that some people could no longer come near them. Others told us that they suddenly discovered occult items in their homes. Some told us that they experienced healing, while others told us that they could experience God's rest again. In the spiritual world, the anointing is extremely visible. When you use anointing oil with faith, and when God's power is released in your situation, it has an immediate effect in the spiritual world. It is like you receive some sort of garment of God's glory over you, just like the face of Moses had God's glory all over it when he came down from the mountain. That means that in the spiritual world you are shining light, and where light shines, darkness is being exposed. They don't like that. That's why you will see that some people who are under the influence of the darkness will no longer come near you. The enemy will still try to make you fall, but it is a lot harder for him to work around you when you carry the anointing. You are no longer an easy target, but you're still a target. He will try to make you believe in his lies. But when you stay close to the Word of God, when you allow the Word of God to live inside of you, you have all the weapons you need to overcome. There is so much more to share about the anointing and the anointing oil. You know, a few years ago I was sitting here in this exact spot thinking I should really quickly write a few studies about the anointing and the anointing oil. And I thought I knew most of it, most of what there is to know about these topics. At that point, the Holy Spirit stopped me and said, "There is more. There is more. But are you willing to go after it? I am willing to give it to you, but are you willing to take this challenge and to go after it?" Well, I took the challenge and I ended up with 345 verses in the Bible that speak about the anointing and the anointing oil. And the amazing thing is that it is not only the Old Testament that speaks about the anointing and the anointing oil. The New Testament actually says a lot about it as well. And now you can learn everything that I have learned throughout this journey, which took me a half year. Because after all my studying and taking all these notes, I ended up with a book called The Anointed Bride. Today you can order your copy and learn the same things that I have learned in that half year.